Hello and welcome back to the next installment in the Road to Nijmegen campaign. And this time we're switched over to the 30 Corps part of the campaign, so we're not American paratroopers anymore, but the Irish Guards. Let's switch everything on. So, our goal is to reach the exit point here and exit our whole force through this forest. To do that we have to clear Hell's Highway, basically. There are three phase lines, Alex, Bill, and Charlie, and here they also mark the Belgian-Dutch border. At my disposal I have a tank squadron of Sherman tanks and two companies of infantry with support weapons. And also air support and artillery will come online later. Okay, so what's my plan? Now, this might be a bit unrealistic, but obviously I know kind of what happened in this battle in real life, because it's pretty famous, you know, the advance up Hell's Highway. And as far as I know, in reality, the German positions were about 100 meters inside the Dutch, or behind the Dutch border, in some kind of forest. So I'm guessing that the German positions are here in this area. Now, I can completely rule out that they are already here. If that is the case, I might actually have a problem. So basically, I'm kind of banking on this. I called in my air support on this area here, and my artillery target reference points. If they are not there, but already here, I might have a problem. So basically, I'm gonna slowly drive a dingo across the road here. If it gets blown up already in this area, okay, then I will have to fight here. But I hope it's not the case. Anyway, that's about it. In terms of planning, I mean, basically it's a really long and narrow map and I have to fight my way through. The terrain around Hell's Highway obviously flooded and muddy and not great for tanks as well. Although in this area here I might be able to maneuver them a bit. Which I will do. Let's start! As I said, in the first area I will be a bit more careful, so I will send the infantry through the forest. Yeah, I hope that doesn't cost me too much time. And here comes the air support. And the big offensive starts. If they are in this forest, probably this will be the area where they blow me up. Planes are flying above, don't seem to be engaging anything yet. Maybe the drums are hidden. Nothing yet. Worst job, EU West. Now, each of them might get blown up at any second here. Unless I was actually right. But I mean, that's what the armored cars are for, really. Okay. I guess I was right, and they are here. Unless they are... See, I have the best trigger discipline ever. Okay, so I can move up the rest of the convoy as well. Kind of feel bad about having sent the infantry in here now. Sadly, I don't have any infantry transport to quickly shift them to the next line, so they will have to go on foot, which costs a lot of time. If this was Red Thunder or Final Blitzkrieg, I might be able to, you know, put them on the tanks, but I don't think that's possible in Normandy. Now I need to move up the rest of the convoy. This will take a while. Especially the end. What the? Tankers. Let's see, where can we move up the armored cars to maybe get a cheeky glance here? I don't necessarily want them to get blown up here and block the road. Just thought about that. This is gonna be a while before we have all our troops deployed forward. Let's inch forward with these armored cars where they have some cover. Somewhere in here I have another armored car, one sec. And we're under fire, okay. Duck down. And he gets shot. Ah, these tank commanders. It's like they attract bullets. But okay, we made contact then. An AT round. Okay, get that thing back on the road. I did. Okay, there's minefields there. Holy shit. But I did see infantry over there that I'm starting to bombard, but there's a tree in the way, never mind. I think that. Oh yeah, okay. Something. Okay, we did lose one of the dingoes. I'm guessing there's an anti-tank gun maybe in this spur, or maybe over there. Ah yes, okay. Sometimes you're just unlucky, mate. Sometimes you're just unlucky. Because I did actually think, like, this is too good a position to not have infantry in it or anti-tank gun. Okay. The sniper team here actually spotted the gun. I don't know how good they are at this range though. Not even shooting, huh? Okay, they shot. Oh fuck! And the gun shot back. Never mind. Oh no, maybe they did get a kill, who knows, but I'm kind of hoping that my planes will spot it soon. They have been circling overhead and not getting any targets. Okay, so there's mines over there. I think my tanks are relatively safe here, but I can't move them up until I take out that anti-tank gun and maybe spot more. I mean, it can't be just one. Now, I'm setting up... For one thing, I called an artillery on that target reference point. And I'm also setting up... Okay, where am I? This forest is a bit hard to maneuver through. I'm also setting up mortars in the forest, as well as the heavy machine gun and stuff here. And with them I will hopefully be able to bombard the anti-tank gun because it's so close to the target reference point. Is So, I have a machine gun nest here, and a gun here. Hmm. And apparently another line of defense in this tree line. Possibly also with an anti-tank gun, but I haven't spotted it yet. And I think the one that took out my armored car was that one. And shooting at my sniper again. I think he picked up his mate's rifle. Pretty good spot for an anti-tank gun, actually. Okay, the first wave of my infantry is here, so I can soon move them into position here. But first I want to use some of that mortar ammunition to maybe take out the gun. Okay, mortars aren't deployed yet, but they're getting there. And as soon as I have them, we can... Okay, the first one's deployed. A bit close to that tree, I hope that doesn't cause any problems. Because I really want to get this advance going again. Also bringing the air forward observer, well, forward. I wonder where if there's a good place for him, somewhere where I can see that other tree line, where I don't have a target reference point. Like, maybe here? That seems relatively safe. That could work, yeah. Nice. And there comes the rest of the force. Okay, let's see how this will go. Okay, it works at least. And due to the target reference point, they should be on point pretty much immediately. Oh shit. Okay, but the Germans saw them as well, obviously. Oh, that's a flak gun or something. Or an armored car? Nah, flak gun, huh? Yeah, and a big one. 37mm, maybe? Oh, that's not good. Okay, I need to get a tank on that as quickly as possible. Oh shit, yeah, they completely hit my mortar crew here. Yeah, it was a tree again. That was better. Nice! We actually hit... Abandoned! How good is that? Okay, good, good. Gun is gone. So we can hopefully pick up whatever's left of that mortar crew, especially the ammunition, set up the mortars again and go to town. Also, a lot of infantry revealed themselves. You can see the spotting contacts here, so we will bombard these with tanks as well, while we wait for the heavy artillery to arrive here. Oh, by the way, where's the air forward observer? I put him here somewhere. I think he's in one of these. We'll put that up somewhere relatively safe, and hopefully this time the planes will see something here. Okay, I'm now shifting my fire to the other infantry positions that we spotted. Now this one I can't target, and if there's anything here, neither, because I can't drive the tanks that far forward. So there's trees in the way, because if I drive them forward, they might get killed by the anti-tank gun. So, because of that, I'm doing something relatively risky. Driving one tank around the corner here. I'm not driving it as far as that dingo here that got blown up, but maybe there's a safe spot from here where I can bombard the rest of that tree line. So, now the Germans obviously are paratroopers, so might be hard to get them out of these positions. But at least I can keep their heads down a bit. Abandoned. Nice. That was a good hit. Okay, and apparently we contacted... The 25 found us as well. Here comes the aircraft controller team.
Fire for effect, out. Fire for effect, out.
Okay, our artillery is going to come down on that puck gun. Over there, moving up the tank. To see if I can bombard this area as well. Where's the artillery strike? Okay, here it goes. Nice. Oh, that didn't sound good. Okay, the tank here aided. But that couldn't have been the gun over there. I think it's coming either from this line or way over there. Okay, so I'm just gonna conclude that this whole area is just off limits for now. Damn it. Well, at least the crew got out. Yeah, that came from the front, I would say. Okay. Under the cover of that artillery barrage, I'm gonna move forward some of the infantry. Now, there's still that one foxhole that the tanks can't see, but I'm gonna shoot my Vickers HMGs and the mortars at that. I also have a Vickers on this flank that pins down this machine gun nest. Okay, that was a good mortar hit. Okay, I'm gonna leave that here as a base of fire, and then move the next platoon, platoon through into this orchard, and yeah, that will work, hopefully. The anti-tank gun seems to be knocked out, so let's move up.
Hello, man.
Okay, they didn't get immediately blown up. That's a good sign.
Hello, ground complete. End of mission. Out.
I think there's still more stuff in this forest, so I actually called in the airstrike on the whole area now. And I hope this time they spot something.
Secure the flanks!
But yeah, anyway, I think that's enough for today. As always, thanks for watching and have a very nice day.